Hello. Assalamu alaikum. Bismillah rahman rahim. Myself, Dr. Navin Joshi. Actually, yesterday I presented in Panchkarma, but my actual topic is in Marma science. This is a very unique science. I am also now watching some students present here. And the topic is Ayurvedic Marma science in non-invasive system for complete health. As you all know that the WHO is focusing on the preventive aspect of health, and the Marma science is a non-invasive method by which we prevent the first goal of the health to all. And this is my presentation. As you all know, yesterday I introduced myself. I am Dr. Navin Joshi, MD in Ayurveda, especially in Kaya Chikitsa, and postgraduate diploma in yogic sciences. I have done my postgraduate diploma in preventive and promotive healthcare. I am an editor of Ayush, Darpan, an internationally known web portal. You can visit http://ayushdarpan.org in English, as well as I am running a peer-reviewed journal that is internationally renowned, that is ayushdarpanjournal.com. Somebody asked about my journal's email ID, so that's why I am putting, this is already mentioned here. So next please. This is the definition of Marma science. As you all are the Bangladeshi peoples, this is a new science. You probably in India also, the peoples must not know about this science. This science is only known to protect the vital points during the surgical procedures, but you are very interested to know that this science is a very unique science which is also used for the treatment purpose. According to medical definition in Ayurvedic literature, the Sushruta Sanhita, it is mentioned that the specific parts of the body which are very vulnerable to trauma are known as the Marma points. And these are the Marma points which is mentioned in Maharshi Sushruta Sanghika. That is, you just locate these Marma points. This is Simant, this is Adipati, this is Sangatak, Prakatika. These are the Marma points of the head regions. You know that any trauma to these places may lead to death or many other complications regarding physiological functions and anatomical configuration. You all know that we protect, during the war injury, these points also. This is a story in our Hindu mythology. There is a battle of Ramayana in which injury to Navi Varma caused the death of Ravana. Next. And the same story is mentioned in our literature that injury to Pad Talhadaya Marma leads to demise of Krishna. Next. And during the in Bible also, you read a reference that there is an injury to Talhadaya Marma and Manimanda Marma by which the demise of Jesus Christ. This is mentioned in the Bible also. And there is one story also, the Sapni Marma injury is mentioned in the demise of Shravan Kumar. This is a very historic character in mythology, Hindu mythology, and his demise was by the injury of Sapni Marma. These are some history in Indian science. And as Bangladesh is very familiar for cricket, and we all know that the 2020 cricket match, the Bangladesh is now champion. So the demise of Philip Hughes is also an injury to Kancha Marma. This is already well known to each and every person. And in Indian cricket history, the demise of cricketer Raman Lamba is also due to the injury of Shankh Varma. These are some references which is mentioned in Ayurvedic as well as the recent scenario, you just watch these things happens. Some interesting facts. As we know in accidental cases, as you all are practitioners, or I think that you all are associated with sometimes with Ayurveda or Unani or homeopathy or other sciences here. So you can say that in accident cases, there are some people die without any massive outside injuries, while some people get extensive outside injury and become healthy after proper treatment. It means there is some vital points that when that are injured, the patient, the person will die. And these vital points are important for the survival of the human being. You can say in your daily practice also this thing. So actually the historical background, you asked with, there is a question arises, how this Marma science comes. There is a, as you know that this is an Ayurvedic science and the Ayurveda, we think that the Vedas are the treasure house of knowledge. And the very traditional sciences, we find a fourfold classifications, that is Atharvani, Angirasi, Daivi and Manusija. This is the classification of the Vedic treatment. And there is an Ayurvedic science, means there is a Veda connections with Ayurveda also. But Ayurveda has a history of 5,000 years back, but 5,000 years before, the peoples are also taking treatment, and that is by these Atharvani, Angirasi, Daivi and Manusija method of treatment. So, historical background of different system of medicine. When we come to the different system of medicine, the Marma science and Marma therapy is the oldest way of healing in the world. How? Ayurveda has in 5-10,000 years. Chinese medical system has a history of 5-10,000 years. And Arabian medical system has 1400 years history. Modern medical science, which is very popular, and it has a history of less than 300 years, while the homeopathy, which is very popular in Bengal, in India also, and I think in Bangladesh also, is a history of only more 150 years or more. So many other folk medical systems were present in different parts of globe time to time, but they are not in existence today. But this science, Ayurveda science as well as the Marma science, is still in existence. This is a reference.
Middle.
You are moving slides. Yes. No, come back. Don't move the slides from there. Yes. So there in our rituals, we are blowing the sangha, by which we are stimulating our marma points of neck. Next. And in Sri Lanka as well as in the Buddhism also, they are blowing the pipes, by which they are also stimulating their kantha marma. Next. So now I just come to the point that the marmas are 107 in number. In neck and head, it is 37. Extremities, it is 44. Back, it is 14. And thorax and abdomen, it is 12. Next. This is the percentage of marma according to the situation. The upper extremity, the lower extremity, the chest, abdomen, the back, and the above neck. Next. This is a graphical presentation of the marma qualities. And it is classified as fatal, delayed fatal, fatal after foreign body removal, disabling, as well as the painful. It is mentioned in Ayurvedic Shushrut Samhita. Next. Yeah, this is the distribution which is mentioned in Shushruta. If you go to the Shushrut Samhita, this is the total Marma 107 points which is explained in Shushrut Samhita. This is the distribution of Marma points in human body. This is the physio-anatomical structure of Marma points. And this is the classification. Now come to the point. This is a very vast science and it will take 2 or 3 day lecture to complete the Marma practical session. So it is not possible here. But I think that if I give some tips to you, and if you practice this in your practical clinical practice, then it will be very beneficial to you, right? I'm just giving you, if some volunteer come here, and I will show you some points in your body. Anybody? Yes, come. One come here. And one pen also, if there is one pen. Then I will just give you some points, marker points of the Marma points of the upper extremity, which will be very beneficial for your patients. If you learn these points, one or two points, and practice in your practical daily clinical practice, it will be very beneficial for you. Yeah. So what's your name, please?
Okay.
Thank you. Just remove your apron. And also your coat. Give a big round of applause for Jay, as he is a volunteer, he is coming here. Tali baja dijiye. So, I am just explaining the Marma points of upper extremity and how it is beneficial. So, this is the joint, the elbow joint, and from the elbow joint, forefinger above, this is the forefinger above, just look at the diagram, and this one is the Marma point, which is very much effective for chest and lung disease. Forefinger, how we measure it? Through the forefinger of the patient. So this is the location. Centrally, you just move your hand like this and put your finger here, and this is the Marma point. Okay? And this point is known as, what this is known as? Yes. This is known as
Ani.
And above the fourth point above, and this one is the Urvi. And this is for important for chest and lung disease. So if there is any patient who is suffering from bronchial asthma, what you have to do, you just press this point 15 to 18 times at 0.8 second is a cardiac cycle. And first of all, this Marma point, and after that, this Marma point. So you can see the results. This is very effective for chest and lung disease. And yeah.
What is the first name?
This is the Ani and this is the Urvi. The Ani and Urvi. Okay? Ani and Urvi. Just remember this. And now, just come to the next Marma point. It's very important. That is the Purpar. This is known as the Purpar Asthi. That is the elbow joint. And on the edge of this elbow joint, one finger below, there is a Marma point. It is known as the Bahya Purpar, and here, this is known as one point below, this is known as the Abhyantar Purpar. Just look this diagram. This is very important Marma point. How you pressurize it? To pressurize it by this way. And this is very important for liver, spleen, as well as the digestive system. For obesity, treating obesity also, as well as to the increasing the weight, as well as to reducing the weight also. This is a very important Marma point. So how you can stimulate? By this way, and you can stimulate 15 to 18 times 0.8 second, as well as here also you can stimulate this like. So you can stimulate by this way. Yeah, just stimulate 15 to 18 times. This is the Abhyantar Purpar Marma and this is the Bahya Purpar Marma. So this is a very important Marma point. It can control, it can balance your digestive fire as well as the digestive system also. So in clinical practice, if you use by whatever treatment you are giving to your patients, either you are giving homeopathy, either you are giving Yunani, either you are giving Ayurvedic treatment, as well as if you are giving allopathic medicine also, just try this point. And you can watch the results, the excellent results. Now just come to the next Marma points. Just below this joint, four fingers below, Yeah, and in the center, this is a Marma point. This is known as the Indrabasti Marma. Indra, we know, Indra is the king of the rain, and Basti is the fourth, the urinary bladder. The Shushrut Sangeeta, it is mentioned as Indrabasti Marma. Means by stimulating these Marma points, the prostatic problem as well as the PCOD problem, as well as the problem related with the kidney, renal system, urinogenital system, you can control your sugar also. So what is aapka kuch nahi jata, you can just stimulate this point, and you can, if you are pre-diabetic or if you are prone to diabetic, then you may prevent yourself by stimulating this Marma point, and this is known as the Indrabasti Marma, and it is very very effective for the senior citizen also, where maximum have suffered from the prostatic problem and incontinence of urine or dribbling micturition. Only by stimulating this Marma point, you can evacuate your urine. So this is very important Marma point. So I request all the practitioners who are sitting here and who are enjoying this session, so please use this Marma point stimulation in your routine practice. It is very effective. Now come to the next Marma point. So this Indrabasti Marma is for all urine related disorders, prostate for men, UTI for ladies, PCOD is very very common problem. So now come to the next Marma point. It is known as Manibandha Marma. As you know, that's for prisoner also, the hathkadi yahi pe lagate hain. Yes. So this is control the violent urges as well as the sexual urges. By stimulating this Marma point, you can control your violent urges, or you can suppress your arrogance, and you can enjoy the relaxed mood. So by how you can stimulate this, just rotate clockwise, wow. Just move this your clockwise and anti-clockwise. So this is a Marma point by which you can control your urges, you can release your stress. So this is a very important point, and this is known as Manibandha Marma. Manibandha Marma. Mani is known as for glands, penis, as well as for the top part of our head. So Bandha means to close, to control. So Manibandha means you can control your sexual urges as well as you control your violent urges by stimulating this Marma point. And so now come to the next Marma point, that is known as Kshipra. Kshipra, that is, you just put your hand like this, and here there is a Marma point. It is known as Kshipra Marma. Nowadays endocrine disorders are very common, and thyroid problems in female also, it's very common. Endocrine disorders are very common. So you can stimulate this Marma points like this, and you can prevent yourself as well as you can control your thyroid disorder by stimulating this Marma point. So there is two aspects. One is the preventive aspect, another one is the curative aspect. And now come to the next Marma point. This is very important. Yes, very good. You are putting and stimulating in right way. Now just come. Just hold it. The Marma point of the upper extremity. Just put your middle finger like this in the center where it comes. And there is a Marma point. This is the one way. And second way is one. Just draw a line from here. And just cut it from here. And so the middle point, there is a point that is known as Tala Hridaya Marma. Tala Hridaya Marma, by stimulating Tala, you can pressurize this, stimulate this Marma point like this, and measure your blood pressure. First you take your blood pressure, systolic and diastolic, and after 15 to 18 point time stimulation, you just take your blood pressure. There, if the blood pressure is above, it will come down, and if it is down, it comes back to normal. So this is very important Marma point, which is known as Tala Hridaya Marma. So this is a very ancient technique, and this technique goes to the China, and they develop it as acupressure. But this technique developed from the Indian subcontinent, and we are not practicing it. So I request all the practitioners of Unani, Homeopathy, Ayurveda, even we are training to the paramedicals also. What's happening? This is for prevention aspect. So if you've got time in morning time, you just stimulate 15 to 18 times this Marma points, and you can prevent yourself from going the hypertension as well as the cardiac disorder also. So this is very important point. So I tried to explain you some important Marma points of the upper extremity. It's not possible to explain all the Marma points. So they are Marma points of upper extremity. You look Ulvi, Ani, Purpar, Indravasti. I have already explained to you. And this is the Talahridaya Marma, which I have demonstrated this Talahridaya Marma. From here, you just draw a line and just cut it from here. And the center of the point, this is Talahridaya Marma. So this is Manibandha Marma, which already I have explained. This is Shipra Marma, and this is the Talahridaya Marma. And there is a question, Talahridaya Marma is soft in all the upper extremities and lower extremities also, same in your feet also, and all the marmas again diagrammatically presented here. So this is the effect of these marma points, stimulation in your whole body. This is the lower extremity marma point, same in foot also. This is Talahridaya, and this is Shipra in foot, and this is Gulfa. This is very important. If anybody suffering from the pain in your lower extremity, like joint pain, I will just give you a stimulation and you got the result. This is very important marma point, Gulfa marma point. If anybody interested, I will. You suffer? Okay, you just come, you just sit here. Just watch, I am just stimulating the Gulfa Marma of this volunteer who is told me that I am suffering from joint problem. Just remove your shoe. Just learn two or three Marma points and you practice it in your clinical practice. Your clinical these tips will be very beneficial for you. And I am privileged to here in Bangladesh to learn you the Indian Vedic science here. This is your Gulfa Marma.
Some students come here and see.
Like this.
Here, आगे आके देख लीजिए.
In this way. Just.
Yes.
Just.
देख लीजिए.
Just do like this. This is very important. This is very important. You can practice. Just do. This is Gulfa Marma. There is a spark. Current has a leg up. Yes. You are feeling a spark? One minute. No pain. You are feeling a spark? Yeah, spark is a sensation, not pain. So you can stimulate this marma point. Duration
okay,
of
beta.
Time 15.
Okay, please.
Just it.
Aye.
If you are interested, I am here at 12 o'clock. Yeah, I will give you the actual stimulation. Just it. So this is also the marma points of the lower extremity. That is Urvi, Ani, Janu, Indrabasti, Shipra and Gulfa. These all are present in lower extremity also. So this is the identification. Two or three marma points I have identified you. So what is the hand effects? Finally, I can tell you that marma therapy is given by applying pressure, vibrating or pinching or application of hot and cold paste soils. But what is the difference between acupressure and marma therapy? Somebody asked with you that what is acupressure? In acupressure, you are using some external instrument, but in marma point stimulation, you are not using any external instrument. You are stimulating your points by your finger only. So that is the difference. And these are some handy facts. You can go through this. So again revise, this is Shipra Marma, this is Shipra Marma of lower limb, this is Talahridaya Marma, and this is Gulfa Marma stimulation, which I have already trained you. This is the Indrabasti Marma, this is the Kulpa Marma. And so thanks to all of you. And again I am thankful to the organizer of this BIMSTEC traditional healthcare expo, as well as the organizers, associated organizers of the Bangladesh Homeopathic Board, Bangladesh Ayurvedic Medical Association, Bangladesh Ayurvedic Medicine Herbal Production Manufacturing Association, Bangladesh Homeopathic Medicine Manufacturers Association, United Medical Association, and the most common, the Bangladesh Ayurvedic Foundation. And I request that you can put this science on your medical syllabus also. This is very important science, and in India we are practicing in our OPD. And I am telling you that I am from Uttarakhand Ayurveda University, and in our university, in OPD, thousands of patients are there. And especially in one day, almost 100 to 150 patients are coming from the Punjab as well as UP, Saharanpur area to Dehradun especially. So it's developed by my guru, that is Professor Sunil Joshi, and we all are master trainers. So I think that this is a very good opportunity for me, that I am able to explore even quite 1% to you people. I think that this is very good for me. So thank you. Thanks all of you.